This is Osborne La Palm Royal Resort, a luxury hotel in Abakale Kebon Estate. One of them owns it. These are alumni of Government Secondary School, Afibu. They're getting ready to visit the alma mater. They came from different parts of the world for this convention. It has not always been like this.
There has always been an old boys association here in Nigeria, but some of us left so long ago we disconnected. We didn't know what was going on in Nigeria.
In 2007, some members of the exit class of 1977 became concerned about the school being in a state of dilapidation.
It was to the point where WAEC was getting ready to close our school because they had no exam hall and they couldn't take their WAEC exams. So they were getting ready to delist us from the list of people that can take exams in their school. So the boys got together, well, men, not boys, they got together and they said, okay, let's get together in Florida and just talk about this stuff.
10 of them met in Florida. The second convention took place in Charlotte, North Carolina, with more old boys in attendance.
At that convention, in one single day, we raised about $87,000 on the spot.
Every year, Government Secondary School Afibu Alumni Association has had a convention. It has taken place in America, Canada, and Jamaica. This is the 12th edition, and they decided to come home.
It is a thing of joy that the old boys decided to, bring it down to here to Nigeria. So I sincerely thank His Excellency, the Executive Governor of Ebonyi State, Engineer Chief Dave Umahi, who is hosting this convention.
Government Secondary School Afibu was established in 1952. After the Nigerian Civil War, the soldiers stayed back in the school premises.
One of the best schools in the then East Central State was occupied by soldiers and refused to go. And nobody could let them go. They were in power. The school was in exile. The government then wanted somebody who could match dialogue with dialogue, sophistry with sophistry. Violence was not accepted. And they lifted Reverend Father Tabo, who was then the principal of CAC Onitsha, another great school, and posted him to Afibu. And Father Tabo was not ready to run a school that was in exile. Father Tabo came here, met the military commander. He spoke Hausa. Father Tabo spoke Hausa more than him. He was born in Jos. After long discussions in Hausa, they agreed to go. But they told Father, go back, we will see you again. Father went back, reorganized himself and came back. At the end of the dialogue, they accepted to go. The soldiers left. Father Tabo now brought the students from Enugu, where they were sojourning, to this place. This place was in a mess.
Reverend Father Nicholas Chukwuemeka Tabo, the seventh principal, worked with the students in the reconstruction of the school.
In two consecutive years, Government College Afibu had the best results in Nigeria. I'm not talking of this.
Father Tabo passed on in 2016, 19 days to his 87th birthday. Appreciative old boys built this new hostel and named it after him. Most Reverend Valerian Okeke, the Catholic Archbishop of Onitsha Diocese, led the group in the official opening.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
Amen.
Our reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew. You are the light of the world.
Lord our God, you have showered us with such great love that we are called and truly are your children.
Thank you that we have gathered here to dedicate this, our great house, to our former principal.
Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for this opportunity. Thank you for this assembly.
Father, we thank you for yet another opportunity to be in your presence.
We pray that everything we do here today and that we continue to do be blessed by you.
The Excellency of Jacob, the disgrace of Nebuchadnezzar, King of Glory, we likewise to quantify our magnanimity.
Almighty God, our Father, we now in your mighty and holy name, declare this hostel opened. May you bless what we do in your holy name. May you now accept the dedication of this house to you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The association also inspected the Virtual Learning Initiative Center, one of their projects.
We have computers there, we have power there 24/7, and students can go there and do their homework and study and connect with internet. And we connect them with subjects. There's something called Khan Academy online, which is like a virtual high school online, and you can virtually learn any subject, especially the science subjects.
The group returned to the hall, and the incumbent school captain, Master Loy Innocent Zikum, read his speech.
Candidly, it pleases me unequivocally beyond ordinary that I, the incumbent school captain, stand before this great gathering this day. My foremost and prodigious exhortation goes to the Almighty God for his benevolence and inexplicable love which must have been boundless in our lives.
The governor of Ebonyi State, His Excellency Engineer Dave Mwezumahi, who is also an old boy, was represented by the Secretary to the State Government, Dr. Kenneth Ogbala.
He asked me to stand in for him here so that I will want to be challenged and do something about my own alma mater when I go back.
Staff and students of the school gave the governor a portrait. Mr. Bonyo Kenyim, the chairman of Afibo North local government area, and some traditional rulers also came. Government Secondary School Afibo Alumni Association has a long list of achievers as members. Coming to Afibo for this convention gave them the opportunity to see the good work they've done. They also took out time to talk to the students. The young ones consider such a privilege.
One thing that will come to my mind, how I'll be like them.
Actually, this is not my first time of experiencing such events. Last year, they came here and handed over the school sick bed. Because of how they always come, I'm always asking a kind of, can I be like them? Or can I be someone like that in future? Said yes, I can be like that because they were once like me.
Most Reverend Valerian Okeke, the guest of honor, encouraged them to make good grades.
I will challenge those who will have 9 A's this year to come and enjoy my scholarship, which I told them 4 years of the university.
They aspire to be great.
I would like to be a barrister at law and also a politician.
I want to be an engineer.
I want to be a pastor.
I would like to become a doctor.
I would like to be a mechanical engineer. I would like to produce more, like all these tractors, like cars, or something like aeroplane, all these things.
Today is Saturday, 13th July. This is Abakaliki, the capital of Ebonyi State. They're here for serious business. First, a minute silence for the departed alumni.
May the soul of the departed rest in peace.
Mr. Nachi John Ulu, the principal, gave a progress report on their alma mater.
The old boys have carried out and accomplished several structural renovation and reconstruction work in the school. They include the following: renovation of the main classroom block, the renovation of the assembly hall, the WAEC exam hall, the school library, the school pavilion, the renovation of the following houses in the school. We have school house, Ibian house, Okpara house, Mboto house, and then the new house, which has been renamed Reverend Father S.A. Tagbo house. Construction and equipping of the school computer laboratory with solar lighting panels, VLOI programs, and set of computers and other learning materials. The painting of most of the school buildings in readiness for the 2019 convention. Reconstruction and equipping of the school clinic, renovation of the physics, chemistry lab, and then drilling of boreholes in the school.
school.
Installation of the VLI program in the school has actually helped the students in their academic performance. Our students have also proved their mettle in other academic competitions. In the 2017 Democracy Day Debate competition, the school emerged first position. The school also took first position at the Mathematics Olympiad competition. They claimed first position in the Inter-Secondary School Science Quiz competition in the state. The best school award in physics by the National Mathematical Center Abuja and the overall winner Africa Youth Leadership Forum Secondary School Quiz competition. In May 2016, the school presented a point stage at the Under-15 Coca-Cola football competition at Enugu. On the 14th of February 2019, the school cricket team won the first prize at the 2nd Southeast Secondary School Cricket Championship, Chika Kukuro's Cup, at Enugu State. Out of the school population of 716 students, 542 are from Ebonyi State, 63 are from Enugu State, 18 are from Anambra State, 40 are from Abia State, 34 are from Imo State, 15 are from Cross River State, 3 are from River State, and 1 from Benue.
The Parents Teachers Association and Agip Oil Exploration Company, which came through the invitation of Mr. Ugo Michael, have also executed projects in the school. In this association are countless doctors, innumerable engineers, PhD holders in every imaginable discipline, professors, captains of industry. The list is endless. The theme for this 2019 convention is Back to the Future. Dr. Mark Abani of the Exit Class of 1975 gave a lecture on it.
In order to drive our next generation of students forward, since the change of society, what we do is we're saying, let's have more mentoring, let's have prizes that make people compete, and let's appreciate the teachers so that they create a new generation of leaders to take this country forward.
A professor of medicine, Professor Roland Ndomegba, who passed out in 1966, gave the keynote address. He spoke about going into the future confidently.
The problem with Nigeria is not just political infrastructure, stomach infrastructure, but the key to Nigeria's problem is the mind infrastructure. Ensure a stable, independent judicial system. Create secondary schools that have curriculum that reflects the third millennium, as well as gives discipline and moral values.
The number one man in Ebonyi State is here. His Excellency Engineer Dave Umahi recounts how he became a student at Government Secondary School, Afikpo.
I started my school class one at Echiago High School. I had a very good outing at Echiago High School in class one. It was a mixed school. I have told this story so many times. And I had two girls in my class. I was really doing well in mathematics. And so they fell in love with me. I didn't understand what love was. And so, in my first term of class two, one of them wrote a piece of paper, "I love you." That was the beginning of the journey. I took the paper, I opened it, I read it, I cried throughout the day. The next morning, I packed my bag, and in Shago Tuburu, just a stone throw, by foot, I trekked back to my village, and I told my father, enough was enough, no more schooling. He said, why? Say again, say to me, I love you. Our father, though a farmer, was a lover of education, made sure his children went to school. And so he took me straight to Government College, Afibo. When I got to the principal office, the splendor was unimaginable.
The government of Ebonyi State, under his leadership, has done a lot in the school.
The perimeter fencing of the school and construction of the Magnificence entrance gate to the school. Reconstruction of the school internal road network with cement concrete technology and solid drainage system. The solar energy street lighting of the school premises and the environment. The donation of a 150 kVA power generating set to the school. And then the reconstruction and renovation of the school admin block.
This member of the exit class of 1982 is not resting on his oars.
The road at the junction is going to be improved upon. We are dualizing from the K Market and it will continue to get to Amasini Junction, you know, put a flyover there. Let me apologize that we didn't finish the entrance as we should have before your coming. My vision for government secondary school is for the alumni to take it over.
Again, he invited his fellow old boys to Ebonyi State for next year's World Convention.
I want to offer a better hosting with better tourist sites, with a better time of mind to offer to host 2020 World Convention. Our Excellency, we take our wives, we spoil them more, we provide first facilities that will take you around. We will take care of our children and I will take care of the men.
His invitation was discussed and many said yes to it. There was fundraising for more school projects. Government Secondary School Afipa Alumni Association's World Convention is not just for the members. The wives and children also come along. This is the government house of Ebonyi State. The governor and his cabinet treated them to sumptuous dinner and good entertainment. It was also an evening for awards.
Ebu Nkama has earned the purple medalist. Congratulations.
I would like to invite my wife up here. Honey, will you please come up here? We did it together. My very first award for the purple legend will go to my own classmate, Dr. Acho Emero, Dr. Azumike Levi. Yes, Ife, please.
Dr. Mwesokwa, the purple legend of KSSA.
This association is well pleased with the governor of Ebonyi State. They call him a good ambassador of government secondary school, Afipa.
It took some of us 10 years to get to $20,000 donation. It took the governor all of 10 hours to get to $20,000 donation.
Engineer David Omani, a purple medalist. Congratulations.
This shall be so much. I am very proud, very distinguished, very honored to be the one who announces that His Excellency Governor David Omahi is a legend of GSS Tribune.
The Association for Consulting Engineering in Nigeria had their first extraordinary general meeting in the South South just 9 days ago in Port Harcourt. They invited you to be their special guest of honor, but somehow you couldn't make it. And they knew that I was coming here. And they said, since you are the only fellow of Nigerian Society of Engineers, who is a governor, south-south of Nigeria, that this will be an opportunity to personally give you this honor.
His Excellency came in 2017 to stay with us in Orlando during our last convention. We asked for one thing, that he won GSSA. He said, is that so? He calculated what it would cost and said, okay, I'm going to add 150 kV generator. I'm going to put lights in all of the schools. And I'm going to also make sure the roads are passable. And he had done all that. Can you give him a hand, please? Well, it is only fitting that the road that comes, starts from the entrance, going all the way around to the other exit or entrance, because it has to have a name. What better name than Engineer Dave Omadi Boulevard? One for the big one, that big gate, and one for the other small one.
Government Secondary School Afibo is 67 years old.
I'm one of the aborigines and I stayed in the school from 1953 to 1957. When I finished, I went to university straight and then came back in 1963 as an education officer teaching in the school. So I knew many of the students, I taught them.
It was one of the top schools in the country and it attracted even foreigners.
I had a choice. The choice was between remaining in Cameroon, at which time there were two secondary schools, versus going out of the country to Government Secondary School Afibo. And I was advised by my teachers and those who knew better than me that this was a better school to go to. And that's why I left Cameroon and traveled to Nigeria to go to that school.
Dr. Obi Anthony Nwasokwa was a school captain in 1967. He made 7 A1s in the West African examination.
The A1s were in Latin, English literature, biology, physics, chemistry, and one A2 in English. I also made A3 in oral English. I studied very hard for the exams, and the hard work paid off. Of course, another key element was I had excellent teachers.
They came from different parts of the world for this convention because of the love they have for their alma mater.
There was a lot of discipline, very, very good teachers.
The school gave us a preparation for leadership and ability to manage men and resources.
Discipline, the act of working hard, depending on God and depending on yourself.
Punctuality was very important. If you came late for an event, you were punished. Everybody was required to participate in games. There were 60 boys in my class. 11 of us became doctors. 7 became engineers. Virtually everyone in my class went on to university and became a university graduate.
In my mind, I think this is the most accomplished class from GSSA. And this may be challenged by my seniors, please, but I have reasons to stake that claim. Number one is, at this convention, Worldcon, we are represented by the largest number of old boys. In fact, at my last count, there were about 20 to 21 of us. No other class has this much representation.
They give generously towards the well-being of the school.
Government Secondary School Afibo gave me a sense of confidence in who I am and what I can do. So when I got to the United States, even though white people look at black people as people who are less capable, I never had that sense that I was less capable.
Seniors have a name they call their juniors.
O-I-N. Oin. If you are 1 year ahead of somebody, he's your oin. He's even worse than a servant. If you ask him to jump, he should only ask one question. How high do you want me to jump? In other words, you control the oins. So anyone below me in school is my oin. Anyone above me, I'm his oin. So it is actually a value of respect to elders. We actually don't know where it came from. It's not any language as far as I know. I only heard about it at Afibo. And no other place has it ever been, you know, I've never seen it anywhere else. And I've talked about it in many places. And no one has ever told me where it came from. Even the Aborigines, the original people, I don't know how. And now that you ask the question, I'm going to find out.
This alumni association is blessed with accomplished men in all disciplines. Government Secondary School Afibo upholds the virtues of Christ. The Sunday service was conducted the same way it was done when they were students. The four-day event ended with a picnic at the home of Chief Dave Nwachukwu, chairman of the organizing committee.
I would say we've had a good outing. There might be a few hiccups here and there, but broadly speaking, the objectives of the Old Boys Association, I believe, has been met.
For 12 years, these old boys have worked their fingers to the bone to get their alma mater back on track. They have a goal in mind.
The vision is to make this school what it used to be. I mean, one of the best schools in the whole country, and in fact, in the entire sub-Sahara Africa. And not just how it used to be, we want to transform it to the 21st century.
We've had a good relationship with the governor, and we're hoping that we can partner with him to change the face of education, not only in Ebonyi State, but our goal is to change the face of education, not only in Ebonyi State, not only in our country, in all the countries south of the Sahara.
Today, Government Secondary School Afibo is a work in progress. Tomorrow, its fame will spread far and wide.